we are lucky enough to have several of these assortments. Assortment is even bigger. Here are the different shapes of the jewels. This one is for a balance wheel, a smaller one. And those are the capstones, the D shape of the impulse stone. And here are the pellets for the pellet fork. And simply, here is the outer diameter, exterior, and here's the inner diameter. So we need just about, we measured 8, 0.08. So it's probably around 10 is the perfect stone. And this is for a balance wheel, because it's curved. And so here are the ones, the smaller ones we're going to use. And they're simply stored in these glass tubes. And then they are all in the exact order. I seem like a nice guy, but if somebody moves them around and I cannot find the proper jewels, I may need a cup of coffee to be a nice guy again. Now, it's essential for easily finding the stuff that everything is back in the right place. And you can see, again, size, made the jewels. So we know the shape of the jewel, we know the outer diameter, we know the inner diameter, and we know how to find them in an assortment, or you have to just order them. And then we have the jewel. And there we go, simply marked, X marks the spot, the jewel. And if I play with the light, you can see here is completely flat, and the other side has got an indentation for the oil. So both sides are different. But we already knew that, because on the inside the jewels are completely flat. And on the other side, you can see the indentation for the oil. You can see here, the jewels are just about flush with the inside and are a bit deeper from this side. So what I'm planning to do is to press it in just about flat, and then later on we are going to adjust the end shake. Again, this is end shake and this is division. So these are the jewels. With end shake you are going to change one jewel, one or the other, so there's not too much end shake. And with division you are moving both to make sure the height is okay of the gear. A small tip in a moment. You can see if I move the part, these two reflect the light at the same time. And that one later, well, that is the perfect way to see if all jewels are in one plane. Of course, this one is a bit lopsided because it hasn't been pressed in yet. But in a moment, when it's pressed in place, then playing with light, you can see those two reflect the light at the same time. So they are in the same plane. And this one should reflect the light at the same time in a moment. And then you know they all are perpendicular or in the same plane. I press it out with a dueling tool, parallel. Now I'm going to use another tool to press it in. For me is this Horia tool. You can see it's just about the same for the build-up. This one is 90 degrees with this. And instead of a handle, you simply got a thread. And for me, that's perfect. These are made by Horia, and I got this one. Oh yeah, this one from the Eterna factory. It's nice. And you can see here number 3 and number 4, because we adjusted this one. They are crazy expensive. But then again, if you treat them well, they last several lifetimes. And these inserts are crazy, crazy expensive. And especially these are insane expensive. And I'm Dutch. So, I think a nice tip. You can buy these Chinese, and they're not that bad. The thread with this is so much finer, so it's easier to control what you're doing. But this one, we adjust it to 4 millimeter here in the top. So we replaced just this insert. So this hole size is different than that hole size. So again, I'm Dutch and I like my tools. So we have to be creative. Because of the conversion, the bits from the dueling tool now fit in the Horia as well, because that is 4 millimeter and the usual is, those are 3 millimeters in diameter. So with the small conversion, and that is not really that expensive, makes this simple Horia tool so much more versatile, because all these parts fit here in as well. So I hope that makes sense. And again, I just want to give you a suggestion or an alternative how to use your tools. But for me, I just like them, and I feel so much more control in the pressure I apply. But then again, I can fully understand if you like to use the dueling tool, and if you like the pressure with that, perfect, no problem whatsoever. We've made several of these parts ourselves. I think even Richard made this one. And that's just, you can see it probably by the light, a flat, completely flat insert. And that was one I really miss in these assortments. I believe we made this one 3 millimeter. And now I would like to support. So I want to press it in, so it doesn't have, the dual hasn't gone, have to go through through the hole. So a flat part here is for me okay. And here you can see flat insert. Again, I think Richard made this one in our workshop. So it's going to push, but then flush, because the diameter is bigger than the jewel. Now I can show you, it's not completely centered, but now you can see it is getting there. And the jewel is slightly bigger than the hole. Do you see that? And it is a press fit. And that, well, this bit here is just flat, so it's going to press, and you can see the insert is bigger than the jewel, so if I press, it's going to be completely flush with the surface. I hope that makes sense. So there's a jewel, and I'm going to twist this one. There are two diameters, and that's simply, if you twist the smaller one, it's going down faster, and the bigger one, you've got slightly more control. Some risk to break the jewel? Yeah, there is. But it doesn't happen too often. Especially if you press it gently and in a controlled way, it should be okay. But then again, it's always a risk. So it's nicely supported on that side. It's straight here, so why not apply some force? There we go. And this is why I like the controlled force on my Horia. Well, we know for sure, again, simple with the torch trick to light it from underneath, like making an X-ray. So now it's in place. Now we have to check mirroring if the reflection is at the same time. Hey, and do you see with a simple rinse that the felt tip marker is gone? And it's slightly, it's not clean enough. But then again, if I play with the light, you see that all jewels reflect the light at the same time. See that? So that's there all in one plane. The only thing we have to check is with the part between the rubies. If the rubies are too deep, the part cannot move. So it has to be just enough end shake to move freely, but without too much play. That's important. So here's the main plate. So nice and stable. Now we have the part, but I am not sure if the jewel is too low. So if I place the escape wheel with the tiny pivots and I place the bridge on top, and the jewel is too low, the pivot will break or the escape wheel will damage. So I have to be very careful just placing the bridge, no screws yet, and just feel and see if the escape wheel has enough room. There is the escape wheel in place. And now with the bridge on top, to see if the bridge is not going to have play like this, I have to be very careful because we measured the pivots. That is 0.08 millimeters, which is kind of small. I do it without oil because we are going to rinse all parts before assembly. So, no hammer time. Well, maybe in a moment. As you can see, the pivot just fits in the inner diameter of the jewel. I press with my finger and I don't feel that the bridge is balancing on top of the jewel, which is a good thing. And now we have to check the end shake. See if I can show you that. There we go. This is a jewel we just replaced. I'm going to use a blower to see if the wheel is moving freely. And it is. But gravity is pushing the wheel down, so there can be a lot of end shake. Simply have to check that. And you can see there's a slight movement possible. And it should be, otherwise it's clamped between the two jewels and it cannot move. So it's moving freely without too much end play. And shake, sorry. If there is too much, and it is enough, yeah, definitely. You just move one jewel or the other jewel, and then you can move the part a bit up, a bit down, and especially with the escape wheel, it has to move with the pallet fork. So it's very easy to move it just a tiny bit about. And then we have two screws. Well, first things first. You've seen the clip from last Friday. How to use screwdrivers, how to maintain them. Very comprehensive video on Chronoglide YouTube. There is the part with the upper jewel just replaced. That one. If I use a tiny oiler, you probably can see just a bit of end shake, but not too much. You see here with the pivot, there's a tiny bit of motion, so hardly any end play, but moving freely. And that's all you want with the jewels. So that's it. Let me see. I showed you the jeweling tool with the lever. I've showed you the Horia with a twisting motion. I showed you the different inserts, the reamers, the outer diameter and the inner diameter. I showed you the micrometer, how to use it, the fine tuster. And the simple trick with reflecting the light so you know all the jewels are in one plane, because if it's a bit lopsided, the inner diameter is getting smaller, so it will damage the pivot, and that's expensive, so you really don't want to do that. So yeah, I think that's about it. If you got any other questions, please leave them in the comments, and I'll answer any comments personally. If you have any questions about watchmaking or future projects, please let me know.